Welcome to this tutorial. In this video, I will be presenting how to display correctly the source code of a loaded object file. This is actually a very typical example where list window shows assembly code mixed with hatched areas, but in fact, this is not the normal case, since it's actually possible to show the full source code in the list window. The cause behind this problem is that the compile environment is often different from the debug environment. And you should know that the path of the source files are part of the debug information included in the object file. That's why, if you change the location of the files, you should inform the debugger where to search for them. For this, there are more than one way, and this tutorial shows you how to provide the debug path directly, how to translate the compile path to the debug path, and how to personalize the debug path. For this tutorial, we are using Trace32 PowerView for ARM with a release version of February 2015. So let's start. I have here a board connected to the debugger and the system is ready for debugging. I will now try to load the simple information only of the ELF file. To do so, use the /no code option. Select the ELF file to be loaded. After loading the ELF file, this warning appears, saying that the source code file is not found in this path. You can open the symbol.list.source window. As you can see here, it says that there is an error loading the source. This is happening because the compile path is actually part of the debug information, and in case the debug path is not found, the source code won't be shown in the list window. Only the assembly code is shown here. But this can be recovered by adding the path to the source files. To do so, click on View, Symbol, Source Search Path. Click on the button Add Dir and select the directory that contains the sources. Now you will be able to see the full code source in your list window. And the state of the source file will change to loaded instead of error. By the way, you can store these settings by clicking on the button Store. That can be loaded in the future by clicking on the button Load of the symbol.sourcepath.list window. This solution is simple and quick and valid for a small project. We can do it in a different way in some other cases where the source code has a tree structure with different subdirectories. So now I will show you how to translate parts of the debug path to fit the path that you have in your debug environment. I have here a VM Linux already loaded. But when I want to show the list window, I got warnings and hatched areas instead of the full high-level code. In this case, it's good to think about using the command symbol.sourcepath.translate. I have under my current path the folder linux3.8.8. So I will cut the part preceding this one, which is shown in the source column. And I will replace it with my current directory. So first copy the part to be translated. Then copy the current path. And here the files will be found and the source code will be shown. Now when you click on one of the files, the file colon will change to the one where the file really exists. And the state will change to loaded. This solution is actually sufficient for large projects, but it has fixed translations that may not fit to all cases. That's why we do provide a third solution for the case where the translation is not fixed. SVN users, for example, may need this. I also have a VM Linux loaded here. If you open the symbol list source, you will remark again that there is an error loading the files. So click on View Symbol Source Search Path and add the base directory. For example, I have here the Linux sources under sources. Click on OK and now reload the VM Linux with the option /stripart. The parameter of this option can be defined this way. First, localize the base directory, which is linux-3.8.8 in my case. Then you should think about removing the rest. So simply tell the debugger that you want to remove parts of the path and tell the term kernel. And you will get the source code correctly loaded. You can also combine the last manips in one command with precising the symbol source path base directory instead of using the view button. If you are interested in further details, you can take a look at the chapter Personalized Debug Paths in training_hll_pdf, which is located under your installation directory /pdf. It's good to know that the command symbol.sourcePath.whereabouts_on is able to show more details in the area window. This is a summary of the presented tutorial, so you can provide the debug path directly for small projects. You can translate the compile path, which is also valid for large projects, and you can personalize the debug path for user-specific configurations. Thank you for watching. Click on subscribe if you want to follow all the rest of our videos.